So I'm working on the GE radio that Bill sent to me. I just got through changing the caps out, the two big black caps. I'm working through my magnifier here. See what I'm doing? It's still not all that easy. But these are the caps. So this is a focus force. This one was a 500 at 6 volts. I had a 470 that was coming in at like 545, 550. And it's a 10 volt cap. That's what I put in there. And then this one was actually a dual cap. One was 250 microfarads, if that's a focus, at 4.5 volts, and the other was 250 at 6 volts. I had two 220s that were coming in around 246, 247. I figured that was close enough because I'm sure that these old caps probably had a 20% tolerance on them. So I think it'll be fine. My main concern is the track, because as I was working on those tracks or removing the components, those tracks are so brittle that a couple of them pulled off the board, and I had to clean off the remaining piece of track with a razor blade and clean it up so that then I could solder to it. And so I put a lump of solder on it and then connected that solder lump to the actual post of the cap. So hopefully that'll work out. I've got my hot glue gun setting up right now because the, let's see if I can point these out. Because the tracks were a little compromised right here. Get my finger out of the way. Right here, right here, and right here. I'm going to put some hot glue in there to just stabilize everything. I'll probably put some on the top where the cap is as well. So we'll see how it works out. Okay, let's see if I can get you guys close enough to see this. So if I can get my pointer here. This cap and this cap are the two caps that were this cap. So you can see the size difference. Okay. This cap is the cap that was that cap. Now, I did notice this cap. I think that's the one Bill changed. But there's also another cap right here. It's a 10 microfarad standing vertical in there. I'm thinking I should probably try and get that changed as well. And there's a few resistors in here that I can check the tolerances on. I don't have the schematic, but I got the color code, so I should be able to figure out what they are and see how they're reading before I put this back together again. So that's where I'm at. Well, I was going to show you where you can see where I stabilized those caps with hot glue, and then the same back here. Just stabilized it all up. So hopefully that'll work. Let me see what I can do with this other cap. All right, so I got that last capacitor out of there. As you can see, it was a 2 UF at 50 volts. That one is one I have. It's 2.2 at 50 volts, so it should be perfect. Again, look at the size difference in those. Anyway, let me get this thing in. Okay, so I got that last cap in. If I can get my fat finger out of the camera, I'll show it to you. So this is right here where my pin's pointing. This is the newest cap. That's that last one, that 2.2. I stabilized it with some glue. That's the dual cap. And this one's a single cap. So the single, the last one, and the dual. So they're all in there. There's the one that Bill put in right there. And I checked the resistors I could get to, and all the resistors seem to be checking pretty good. So I'm going to throw a little bit of lubrication on the dowel cord. Thank you. That's what it's called. And so I'm going to put this thing back together, put some power to it, and see if it does anything. I don't know. I feel like I compromised the traces a little bit, so I'm a little nervous about it, but we'll see. Okay, so I'm going back together with it. Pretty much got it all back together again here. I'm getting ready to close it up, make sure everything's not pinched and everything's where it belongs. I think everything's pretty good shape. I'm going to put you back,
right, back in the tripod. Now if I can stay out of the way of the camera and watch these wires so nothing gets pinched.
Together. I clean these little wheels off a little bit too in the grooves on the tops through here. Maybe you can see that or not. I haven't really cleaned the rest of the radio yet, but I did clean that, so it looks like the dial's working good. So I guess I'm gonna go upstairs and see if I got some 4 AA's. I got to clean up the. I want to clean up the terminals a little bit in there too. They aren't looking the best in the world, so let me hit those a little bit, and I'll go get some batteries and see if this thing comes to life or not. All right, I got it powered up using my homemade power supply. Putting 6.3 volts into it. It wouldn't work with the batteries. I got it on Fox News right now. It's got a little bit of static in it. It working. I think I need to do a little bit more to it. Or it needs something else. I gotta spray some pots out on it or something. But so far so good. I must not have screwed that trace up, so that's good. I gotta figure out why the batteries aren't working in it. Or new batteries. I gotta trace the circuit out. Okay, here we are back on the GE radio that Bill sent me. So, couldn't make it work with the batteries at all, and come to find out, all of the lower battery pads were so corroded that the wires were rotten. So I wound up making new wires. That's what these white with red tracers are. For the bottom, and soldering new wire on both the top to the bottoms, and then a new wire from the negative down here that goes over here. I used a different wire than what I was using here. I could have used something else. I probably should have. That was the first wire I did before I realized everything else was so rotten. The red wire up here at the top is fine, but all the rest of the wiring is fine. I went ahead and there were some wire clamps like that one right there. I didn't do it to this one, but I did it to this one. I heat shrinked around it to protect it. So I'm getting ready to button it up. Oh, and one other thing I did, had a lot of that heavy static going on, and I took and cleaned the little contact right here, the little contact right there. Get where you guys can see this thing. Try this again. A little contact right there. And I cleaned that with some a little bit of sandpaper, fine sandpaper, and alcohol. So we'll see what that does. Getting ready to flip it back over here and put the batteries in and see if it's going to run on the batteries yet now that I got the wiring changed. I shall come back. Alrighty. So here we are, the final product of the GE SportsMate. So I went in, I changed all of these capacitors. You see my hand or not? But this one, and this one, which was a two cap, and then the one Bill changed. So basically five capacitors. Then I had to go in and fix the battery wiring, which was all corroded up and rotten. So that was a bunch of work actually, get all that out and make all new wiring put in there. So then I thought I was good to go. I reassembled, put the batteries in, and nothing. I'm like, no, wait a second. The last night I played it for an hour, powered up with my bench supply. And I knew that I'd run new wires. And I'm like, what the heck? So I took it back apart, and lo and behold, the switch had quit working. So I had to take the switch apart, and so I took the switch apart, cleaned the contacts in the switch, cleaned the wiper on the volume control, and put a complete brand new wire. I think in the previous little video I showed you, I had spliced the negative. And this one up to the switch. It wasn't the issue. But while I was in there and had to take the switch apart anyway, I decided just to go ahead and run new wire in there. So I did. So, he got new wire in there. Anyway, here's the result. I think it looks really nice. Cleaned up really nice. And here it is playing.
And are always top of mind to discuss and why some others aren't. But Daniel Jones is, for a guy like Josh Allen at Buffalo, isn't. Like, you know, I mean, it's... And both guys are first-round picks, all those things. But there are certain guys that you are going to dissect every single throw and game, and there's other guys that just become an afterthought. And I realize there's only so much oxygen and time to talk, you know. But, man, it's just bizarre how that works.
Look at what we did to Sam Darnold in the span of a week.
They were pretty much already picking up.
Mono to beating the Cowboys.
My local station, but you guys got to realize I live out in the boonies. There's nothing much around me.
You know, useless.
For about 75 miles.
How like absurd it's gotten.
I did actually align it last night.
Daniel Jones hasn't even had the craziest season in New York City for a quarterback. You know, I mean, for
what
has gone on. And considering he's a rookie, I think we need to slow our roll on just, on really with anything with him, considering where the Giants are.
So, Bill, thank you very much. I love it, and I will take good care of it, and it's going to accompany me down here in my basement a lot. So, thank you so very much, and that's it for the GE SportMate, courtesy old 64 Goat. As far as the rest of my viewers, thank you for watching Greg's Vintage Workshop.